Can PRP hair loss treatment help to slow down aggressive MPB balding? I've been diagnosed with androgenic alopecia. The progression was steady until it sped up last year. I've lost much density in the last couple of months, and hair loss seems to continue aggressively. I can't, don't want to use Propecia or minoxidil due to side effects. My question is, how effective is PRP for slowing MPB down? Is it any good as a standalone treatment or just a waste of money?
Thank you for your question. You're asking a question whether or not PRP can be effective for male pattern hair loss. And you state in some of the details of your question that you have noticed that the hair loss has become a little bit faster. And you're asking, can PRP be a standalone treatment for male pattern baldness, or is it a waste of money? Well, I can certainly give you some guidance on this question. A little bit of background, I'm a board-certified cosmetic surgeon and fellowship-trained oculofacial, plastic, and reconstructive surgeon. I'm also the founder of Trichostem Hair Regeneration Centers, a system that we developed in our practice using PRP with material called extracellular matrix, which I'll explain more about later, which is a non-surgical solution for male and female pattern hair loss. We treat patients from all over the world, so I'll give you some perspective on how we do our evaluation and how we make a decision about recommending this particular treatment. To begin with, understand that in addition to PRP for hair loss, I actually use PRP a lot in my practice. PRP is platelet-rich plasma. This is a concentration of the wound healing and growth factors necessary when someone has an injury. And in different specialties of medicine, starting with oral surgery, then orthopedic surgery, and now in aesthetic medicine, PRP has been invaluable in helping develop basically the things that we love most and need the most when it comes to aesthetics. And this includes improvement of blood supply, improvement of collagen, improvement of tissue quality. So in our practice, we use PRP for acne scars, for under eye dark circles, for scar treatment. In the capacity of hair loss, I can tell you that historically PRP has been fairly well established in helping in wound healing when it comes to hair transplant, and it does stimulate hair growth. Now the question you're asking is it going to slow down hair loss? And the answer, in my opinion and from my experience, is no. I think PRP as a standalone procedure is not adequate to stop hair loss. It's comparable, in my mind, to the treatment like minoxidil. In our practice, we use PRP in combination with a material called extracellular matrix, which initially was intended for improving our outcomes with hair transplant. When you think of hair transplant, you want the hair grafts to heal better and be more likely to grow, and you want the donor area to heal better so that it's not as obvious in terms of scarring. Well, a side effect was that thinning hairs appear to get thicker. Over several years, we developed a system to treat hair loss long-term with this treatment, and we call it hair regeneration. What we're doing is we've developed an algorithm where, based on gender, type of hair loss, degree of hair loss, and a few other factors and variables, we basically are able to non-surgically treat thinning hair for both men and women. In terms of long-term benefit, up to this point, and this is over many years of doing this, 5 years out, the majority of people who we've treated and we have continued to follow, and we follow people very closely, continue to have improvement. This happened to be beneficial for a lot of people, particularly men who were concerned about long-term sexual side effects from finasteride, the drug with the trade name Propecia. So we were able to prove from an early stage of development that the injection alone was able to stop progression, initiate regrowth of hairs that were not growing, as well as induce the shedding of thinning hairs so that thicker hairs would grow in. And one other big distinction between hair regeneration and PRP alone, with PRP as a standalone treatment, our patients, people who come to us after getting a few PRP treatments elsewhere, will say that they were going somewhere for monthly visits, and they really just did not enjoy getting their scalps poked at every month and not understanding when is there would be an end point. So understanding that it's consistent with what I was saying, in that PRP can induce a short-term stimulation of hair growth, but in terms of long-term benefit, hair regeneration has been very successful with a single injection helping people continue to grow hair for more than 5 years. We have protocols where in some patients we'll do a treatment again depending on observations and particular parameters, but we can, even if we do a second injection, it'll be somewhere around 15 months or so. And then beyond that, people continue to do well. So clearly there is a benefit to PRP, but not PRP alone. And so I think at this point, learn more about your options, including medical, surgical options, as well as PRP and hair regeneration, and do something sooner rather than later. This is another point I do make with a lot of our patients, is that the earlier we catch someone, this is a limitation of our procedure, we need to have viable hair follicles. If someone comes in practically bald, they're in a less advantageous position as someone who is in the early to middle stages of their hair loss. Basically, the inventory of hair follicles is critically important. So we've treated people as young as 17 years old, and we've been able to successfully stop aggressive genetic pattern hair loss. So I hope that was helpful. I wish you the best of luck, and thank you for your question.